Hey everyone, in this video I'll be showing you some of the basic Linux commands that every programmer should know. So let's get started. So currently I'm in my home directory in my Ubuntu OS. So I will just go to terminal. So for doing that, just right click and just click on open in terminal. So this is my terminal over here. So first command that I'm going to show is cd, alright. So cd command has various purposes. I will show you the most common purpose of cd. So I am in this particular folder. Now I want to go inside this particular data folder. All right. So for that, what we will do is you need to specify cd and this particular folder name, which is data. So if I just now hit enter, so here you can see now I am inside this particular data folder. So the same command is used in Windows as well, I guess. So now let me just go inside this data folder. And next command that I'm going to show is pwd. So pwd, if I just now hit enter, so this will basically show the entire path of my folder. So home is my home directory, this is my username, and this is my data folder which I am currently inside. So this is also like a most commonly used command. And next one is going to be the touch command. So touch command is used to create a file inside our folder. So currently my data folder is empty. So if I just now go and type touch, I will just specify a file name, which is my file dot txt, and hit enter. And if I just now go to my data folder, here you can see I have a file over here. So touch can be used not only to create dot txt files, but any files. So for example, let me go with touch, I'll go with mypro.c. so here you can see it's a dot c file as well. So you can create this by using like touch command. And next one is going to be the ls command. So ls command is going to be just list the files or the contents present in a particular directory or a folder. So it's just ls. So here you can see I'm having two files. As you know, just now I created, this is this text file and this is this dot c file over in our data folder. And in order to move one folder behind, let's suppose say that I again want to go to the home directory from the data folder. So for that, we will be using cd space dot dot. So here you can see now I have gone one folder behind. So to come again, it's just same thing. We will be using cd data. All right. So now I will just go inside my myfile.txt and let me just enter some values. Let me go with numbers 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, some just random numbers. So I'm now saving it and I'm just now closing it. So in order to view the contents present in the file, we will be using the cat command. Cat, I will just specify the file name, which is myfile.txt over here. So here you can see I'm getting the contents present in the file, and cat command also has many other functionalities with it. So next command is going to be the mkdir, which basically helps us to create a folder. So let me just now do that, mkdir. I will just specify it as new folder, and if I just now hit enter, so I will just go to my data. Yeah, so here you can see our new folder has been created. So that's the function of mkdir. So now let's see a command which is exactly opposite of mkdir, which is rmdir. As the name suggests, it is used to remove a particular folder. So rmdir, new folder. So this particular folder present here is going to go now. So I'll just hit enter. Yeah, and here you can see that folder has vanished. So next I will show you the copy command. All right, so let me also create another text file, since I am having only one text file over here. So let me just go and use a touch command, touch second text dot txt, just a random name. So now here you can see we are having two text file, but our second text is now empty. This file is basically empty, and this my file has values. So now I want to move all these values present in myfile.txt to the second text file. So for that, we will be using the copy command. So it's cp, first argument is going to be the source. Here it is myfile.txt. And the second argument is going to be the destination file. That is the file to which all the data is going to get copied. So in my case, it is second.txt.txt, and I'll just hit enter. Yeah, so now if I go to my second file over here, so here you can see I've got all the data copied over here as well. So now I will go to my myfile.txt and let me just add some more numbers to it like this. Yeah, that's fine. I'm saving it. So now I will be showing you the head and tail commands. So head myfile.txt. So head command basically displays the first 10 lines of a particular file. So here you can see I'm getting the first 10 lines, and the exact opposite for head file is going to be the tail command. So tail myfile.txt. So head command displayed the first 10 lines of a file, and tail command is going to display the last 10 lines of our file. So in this case, we will be getting the numbers from 5 to 15. All right. So 5 to 15 or 14, because 5 to 14 actually. So this is the tail command. And let's suppose say that we want to display like the first 5 lines of a file. So for that, we will be using head hyphen n file name dot txt. So this will basically display the first 5 lines. So here you can see, so exact same thing applies for tail command as well. So I think these are the most commonly used basic Linux commands. So if I forgot anything, you can please comment down in this video. And I hope you have found this video useful. I've also done many other programming tutorials in C, C++, Java, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL. So do check other videos of my channel. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.